Wind out there today is going to stick with us much of the day. Well, to buy or to rent, the answer for more and more people these days seems to be to rent. But is that really the best option? Here to offer us a reality check on renting is Dick Burke, the Senior Vice President and General Manager of Apartments.com. And he's joining us live in Chicago, courtesy of Apartments.com. Good morning, Dick.
Good morning, Deirdre. Thank you for having me.
Well, thanks for coming on. So let's talk a little bit about the greater Sacramento area. And what have you noticed in terms of our renting?
Well, it's amazing. We were sensing that there was a disconnect nationwide and in Sacramento between what folks thought rent was and what the rent actually was. So we commissioned a study using all our own internal data at Apartments.com, and it was very interesting. We came out. Most markets, there is a big disconnect. Folks think that rent is a lot cheaper than it actually is, and that causes problems. If folks think they're going to pay X and they got to pay X plus, that causes problems. Sacramento was very interesting. Sacramento was the opposite. Folks in Sacramento for a one-bedroom expect to pay about $850 a month for that one-bedroom in the Sacramento area. In reality, the average cost for a one-bedroom in Sacramento is about $750. So there's about a 13% savings there, $100 a month, which adds up, right? If you are a knowledgeable buyer, and Apartments.com is all about trying to turn you into a knowledgeable buyer when it comes to renting your apartment.
So what are the biggest,
what are the hidden fees?
What are the hidden things that people are not taking into account when they are signing a rental agreement?
Well, it's not so much about hidden fees, Deirdre. It's about knowing the right property and knowing the right neighborhood and knowing what the market is. In Sacramento, folks are coming in and almost offering to overpay. They think it's going to be $850, and it's only $750. It's really very, very interesting. So the first step is know what you can afford. And the general rule of thumb is somewhere between 25% and 30% of your monthly salary can go towards housing. We think that's a good rule of thumb. Then what you got to do is you got to say, okay, listen, I know what I can spend out. Now, how do I find it? Go to a site like Apartments.com where you can see hundreds of properties in the Sacramento area, whether it's Midtown, wherever, Hagenwood, and find out what is available. And you'll find wide variations, Deirdre, between rental rates. Some in Midtown might be more expensive, Hagenwood might be less expensive. So location is one big driver of price. Mm-hmm. The second one is the number of amenities in a property. You might say, hey, listen, I don't need a health club, I don't need parking, I don't need to have my dog or my cat, I don't have pets. That will impact price as well. So what you really need to do is you need to get smart, and then you need to get flexible. And by flexibility, I mean, you might say, hey, listen, I can't afford, location's really important to me, I can't find anything in the right neighborhood. Then you got choices. Maybe you want to get a roommate. A two-bedroom is never going to be twice the cost of a one-bedroom. That's one way to really get in a much more affordable
living
situation.
Add some flexibility to it. All right, hey, Dick, thanks for the tips there. We appreciate it. It's interesting to see that we're actually paying less than we think we should be paying. That doesn't happen very often.
Absolutely.
All right, thanks. We appreciate it. Stick with Apartments.com. Sorry, we're running out of time.